Somewhere, hidden amongst thorny brambles, is a little kingdom of elves and fairies. Everyone who lives here is very, very small.
I'm Ben Elf.
And I'm Princess Holly. Come on, let's play.
Wait for us.
Ben and Holly's Little Kingdom. Today's adventure starts at the Great Elf Tree on Christmas Eve.
Snow!
Come on, elves. Let's get the elf plane loaded.
Radio! Wind the engine.
Roger that, Mr. Elf. Wind the engine.
Radio!
What's happening?
Dad has an important job to do.
What kind of job?
He's flying to the North Pole.
The North Pole?
Yes, we're making our final delivery of toys to Father Christmas.
Ooh.
Flight 1000, ready for takeoff.
Flight 1000, you are cleared for takeoff.
Roger that, Control.
To Father Christmas.
Well, who do you think makes all Father Christmas's toys?
Elves?
That's right, us elves.
Ah.
Elves work all year deep underground in the elf factory making toys.
Then, in December, Ben's dad flies to the North Pole and delivers the toys to Father Christmas.
Does he land at the North Pole and meet Father Christmas?
No, he never lands. He drops the toys by parachute. Then Father Christmas wraps the toys up and delivers them to the children of the world.
All the children? Even our friend Lucy?
Oh, yes, even Lucy.
I love Christmas.
And I love snow.
Me too.
I wish it was snowing now.
Yes, it's Christmas Eve. When's it going to snow?
Maybe it's time for a weather forecast.
Weather forecast?
Yes, we can use my elf weather detector.
Wow. So can this machine tell if it's going to snow?
Of course.
How does it work?
I listen to the weather through this giant ear trumpet. It's so sensitive, I can hear a butterfly flapping its wings in Africa.
Can you hear any butterflies?
Don't talk loudly into the trumpet.
Sorry, wise old elf.
Now, please stay quiet. Ah, interesting.
Is it a butterfly?
No, I can hear weather.
What sort of weather?
There's a chance of sun or rain with clear skies or clouds.
Is it going to snow?
I can say it certainly might, but then again, it might not.
Oh. I know. Let's ask Nanny Plum if it's going to snow.
Why ask Nanny Plum?
Nanny can tell the future.
Ha! This I must see.
Nanny Plum! Nanny Plum! You can tell the future, can't you?
I certainly can.
Can you tell if it's going to snow today?
Yes, I'll use my special snow forecasting globe.
Oh, I see. You gaze into the crystal ball and it tells our fortune, I suppose.
No, you just shake it, like this. There we are. It'll snow today.
Hooray!
Stop, stop, stop. How on earth can that thing predict the weather?
It's never been wrong.
What if you shook it in the summer?
Well, you don't shake it in the summer, obviously. That would be silly.
Well, you can't tell exactly when it's going to snow, can you?
Yes, I can. It's going to snow now. Abracadabra!
That's cheating.
No, it's not. Make it snow.
Nanny's made it snow.
Let's go and see it.
What?
But where is the snow?
Yeah! Nanny Plum!
It's snowing inside!
Wow! Snow! Snow!
Let's play snowballs!
Oof! Nanny Plum! It's snowing in the sitting room! Is this your doing?
Yes, it is!
Inside is for sitting in armchairs and reading. Outside is for snow.
Inside, outside, whatever.
Nanny Plum, you're fired.
Don't be silly.
I'm taking away your wand until you learn how to control your spells better.
But what about the snow?
Not another word.
Aww.
Everyone out.
Now Daddy's taken Nanny Plum's wand, she won't be able to magic any snow.
No, we won't have any snow for Christmas.
There's always a chance it might snow anyway.
I can hear something.
Is it snow?
No, it's the elf plane.
Dad's back from the North Pole.
That's the last delivery done.
Dad, did you see snow?
Yes, lots of it. Enough snow to last me a lifetime.
Now you've finished your work, Mr. Elf. Are you on holiday?
Holiday? Good gracious, no. It's Christmas Eve. There's work to be done preparing tonight's elf and fairy feast.
Oh, yes, the midnight elf and fairy feast.
On Christmas Eve.
With music.
And singing.
And lanterns.
Yes, and those lanterns don't hang themselves up. To work.
Stop, Mr. Elf. It's about time you had a rest.
A rest?
You've been working hard all year. Just sit down and relax for 5 minutes.
I can give you 3.
You work too hard.
Elves like working hard. And I'm an elf.
Oh, dear. You really must relax. Just say, I'm on holiday.
Well, all right. I'm on holiday. Ah... That's nice.
Hello? Wise old elf speaking?
Ho, ho, ho! It's Father Christmas here.
Oh, Mr. Christmas.
We seem to be missing some toys. I can't find box 571.
Box 571?
I need those toys before tonight. Or some children will not get their Christmas presents.
Never fear, Mr. Christmas. We will get the box to you. I will deliver it personally.
Box 571? It could be anywhere. We'll never find it.
Is it this box, Dad? The one that says Box 571?
What?
Well done, Ben. You found it.
To the elf plane. We leave immediately.
Well, that was a nice holiday, while it lasted.
Are you going back to the North Pole? Can we come?
Can we, Dad? Please?
Please, Mr. Elf.
I don't mind who comes, but we must leave straight away.
Hooray! Brilliant!
I'll just get my wands back from King Thistle and then...
There's no time for that, Nanny. We need to get these toys to Father Christmas right away.
Elf honor is at stake.
Ready for takeoff, Captain?
Everyone on board.
Ben, it's snowing.
Oh, wow!
Snow!
You see? My snow globe is never wrong. What do all these buttons do?
Don't touch anything, please, Nanny Plum.
Wind the engine. Righty-ho! Ready for takeoff. We're not going to play in the snow. We're just dropping off the toy box and coming straight home.
So we won't meet Father Christmas?
Good gracious, no. We're on a mission. There'll be no playing in the snow and no meeting Father Christmas.
Join us in our next episode when we play in the snow and meet Father Christmas. Somewhere, hidden amongst thorny brambles, is a little kingdom of elves and fairies. Everyone who lives here is very, very small.
I'm Ben Elf.
And I'm Princess Holly.
Come on, let's play.
Wait for us!
Ben and Holly's Little Kingdom. Today's adventure starts at the meadow.
Redbeard the Elf Pirate.
Hello, Holly.
Hello, Nanny Plum.
Hi, Barnaby.
Hi, Ben.
Something very exciting is happening.
What's that?
My Uncle Redbeard is returning from the sea today. He's an elf pirate.
Wow, a pirate.
We're going to meet him at the river. Do you want to come along, Holly?
Nanny Plum, can we go meet the elf pirate?
Why not?
Hi, Dad.
Oh, hello, Barnaby.
Is Uncle Redbeard here?
That's him now.
Yo-ho-ho!
Wow!
Anchors away! Shiver me timbers, if it ain't me nephew Barnaby.
These are my friends, Ben and Holly.
Hello, Mr. Redbeard.
A pleasure, me hearties.
And I'm Nanny Plum.
A plum is a sweet fruit indeed. The honor is all mine, missy.
Oh.
For I am Redbeard, the elf pirate. Hello, Fred.
Hello, Nigel.
Uncle, what was it like being a pirate on the sea?
It were a strange life for an elf. Long days staring at the sea, looking for boats. No one to keep me company except Polly.
Polly?
Yes, me faithful parrot. This is Polly.
Ooh.
Pieces of eight.
She alone was my companion as we sailed through the endless waters.
Pieces of eight!
The conversation must have been riveting.
Pieces of eight!
Were you an evil, nasty, bad pirate?
Well, no. The thing is, it's quite hard to be a pirate when you're as small as an elf. All the other boats are so big.
Oh... So you didn't do any piratey things at all?
Of course I did! What would any self-respecting pirate be without treasure?
Ooh!
And here's me treasure map.
Wow!
Now then, somewhere on this map is the hidden treasure.
It's a map of the Little Kingdom.
Aye, but that's just the start, me shipmates. There'll be a big search with lots of clues.
There's no need for a big search and a lot of old fuss. I can magic you some treasure right here. Abracadabra.
No! That's cheating!
Yes, that's true, Nanny Plum. It's not as exciting.
All right. Just trying to save a bit of time.
Hmm. There's an X in the meadow. Is that where the treasure is?
There's only one way to find out.
To the meadow.
Wait! We may need a spade. Pirate treasure is often buried in the ground.
Ooh! It's Fleur and Strawberry.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, me hearties. I'm Redbeard, the elf pirate. And this is me friend Polly.
Pieces of eight!
Ooh!
We're looking for hidden treasure.
Wow!
Aha! There's a riddle on the back of the map.
What does it say?
Roses are large, the sky is big. Mix them together and you'll know where to dig.
Oh!
That's confusing.
Roses are large.
And the sky is big.
But how do you mix them together? It can't be done. It's silly.
That's why it's a riddle, me lovely. It's a puzzle you have to solve.
The roses are red
and the sky is blue. Mix them together and you get
purple.
It must be buried under the purple flower.
Aha! Very good! Very clever!
Come on, Ben. Let's dig for the treasure.
Yes, elves are very good at digging.
And we're elves.
Dig ho, dig, dig ho, dig, 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 dig. Dig ho, dig, dig ho, dig, dig.
Oh, what's that?
It's another map.
That's right. You can't just find the treasure with one clue.
Why not?
That wouldn't be fun, me little mermaid.
Oof.
The X is marked on Gaston's cave.
Let's go there.
Hello, Gaston. We think there might be some pirate treasure in your cave.
Ah, I used to live here myself many moons ago. Probably before you were even born, Gaston. I like what you've done with the place, Gaston.
Mr. Redbeard, what does the riddle say?
Aye, the riddle. I'm easily spotted, and where I lay, you'll find the clue to show you the way.
Easily spotted? What's that?
Gaston has spots on his back.
And Gaston's bed is where he lays.
It's another map.
Ooh. The X shows the little castle.
Impossible. I've dusted every nook and cranny of the little castle. I would have found it.
Maybe it's well hidden, me sweetheart.
To the little castle.
Hello, everybody.
Pieces of eight!
Oh, goodness me.
Daddy, we're searching for pirate treasure.
My uncle is Redbeard the Elf Pirate.
Your Majesties.
A pirate, eh?
Not a nasty pirate, Your Majesty. A good pirate. For I am Redbeard the Elf Pirate.
Well, that's all right then.
So, where's this treasure?
Up above the castle, I point to the sky, and hidden underneath me is where the clue lies.
Well, that's just nonsense.
I know. The roof is above the castle.
And it points to the sky.
Very clever, Your Majesties.
But that's ridiculous. I've dusted on top of the roof 100 times.
Maybe it'd be under the roof.
I've an idea. Take a look under the roof, Nanny Plum.
Oh, are you sure, Your Majesty?
I command it!
As you wish.
Zip, zap, zap! Roof lifts up!
Oh, I meant take a look through the attic door.
Oh.
Another map!
The X is at the river.
Let's go!
Wait for me!
Oh, we're back where we started.
Where is the treasure?
Uncle, what does the riddle say?
up and down and side to side, it's inside this thing I really hide.
The ship goes up and down.
And it goes side to side.
Yes, the ship!
So that's where the treasure is.
That's right. You worked it out. Here it is, me hearties.
Oh!
Thanks for your help in finding me treasure.
But we're back where we started, and the treasure was here all the time.
But didn't we have fun?
Aye, Captain Redbeard.
I certainly enjoyed it.
I suppose it was fun, in a way.
Fun is what it's all about when you're an elf pirate. And I'm an elf pirate! And now, I must return to the distant waters.
Goodbye, Uncle Redbeard.
Goodbye, Barnaby. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Hoist the mainsail, Polly. Weigh anchor. Scrub the decks.
He's in the right.
Let's get the ship underway.
When I grow up, I want to be a pirate. Aha!
Me too!
And me!
And me!
You'll be seeing me again! Don't forget the name! Redbeard, the Elf Pirate!
Peace of the night!
Somewhere, hidden amongst thorny brambles, is a little kingdom of elves and fairies. Everyone who lives here is very, very small.
I'm Ben Elf.
And I'm Princess Holly. Come on, let's play.
Wait for us.
Ben and Holly's Little Kingdom. Today's adventure starts at the Little Castle.
King Thistle is not well.
Ooh!
Achoo!
Daddy, you've blown our cards over.
I can't help it, Holly. I'm very ill.
You've just got a cold, that's all.
No. It's not just a cold. It feels worse than that.
Daddy's a bit grumpy.
Daddy's always grumpy when he's ill.
Then why don't you use a little fairy magic to make me better?
Darling, you know fairy magic can cure everything except the common cold.
It's not a common cold. It's something serious and it needs sorting.
All right. I'll try a little magic. Abracadabra!
Achoo! Now I'm sneezing and I've got a stuffed-up nose.
Sorry, but I told you magic wouldn't work. Perhaps you should see the elf doctor. Is that the elf doctor? Yes. The king is ill. Sneezing and a stuffed-up nose. I know, but he thinks it's serious. Thank you. Goodbye. You rest in bed, darling, and wait for the doctor.
The doctor is here.
That's just the wise old elf.
I'm not just the wise old elf. I'm also a qualified doctor.
Oh, I see. Well, doctor, I am not well. I keep sneezing, my nose is blocked up, and my head aches.
I see. Could you open your mouth and stick your tongue out? Now look up, look down, and wiggle your feet. Now flap your arms like a bird and whistle. Interesting.
At last! A thorough medical examination by a qualified doctor.
What you have is a case of acute viral nasopharyngitis.
Aha! You see? It is something bad.
Otherwise known as the common cold.
Is that all?
No. You're grumpy as well.
Well, Doctor, can you make me better?
Let me see what I've got. Ah, this should do the trick.
Does it taste bad?
Let's just say it doesn't taste good.
I'm not having it.
Daddy, we all have to have medicine when we're ill.
Oh.
That's interesting. I wasn't expecting that. Well, it does say cough mixture.
I know a recipe that can cure all kinds of colds, whether they be common or not. Expanding hands, itchy ears, hairy teeth, smelly noses, baldness. Ah, here it is, the common cold. I just need to find the right ingredients.
Can we help you, Nanny Plum?
Of course.
Nanny Plum, what's in this medicine of yours?
Oh, just blackberry juice, lemon and sugar and a few other things.
Nanny, what other things do we need?
Let's see. A dewdrop from a spider's web.
Ooh.
The slime from a slug.
Ooh.
And un rond de grenouille.
What's that?
Frog burp.
Ugh. You'll never get Daddy to drink that.
Oh, no. It would be most unfortunate if anyone were to drink this. This is a potion for rubbing on his feet.
Ooh.
Right. First, we need a dewdrop on a spider's web.
Look, a dewdrop.
Stop, Holly! It's not a good idea to fly around Madam Spider.
Why, Nanny?
The flutter of our fairy wings is like a fly. And she likes to eat flies.
Eat flies?
Ugh! Shh! Yes. That's just what spiders do. You like to eat ice cream. Spiders like to eat flies. They have very smelly breath. Excuse me, Madam Spider. Could we possibly collect a dewdrop from your lovely web here? It is to make some medicine for the king. Madam Spider says yes.
I'll get the dewdrop, Nanny. Elves are very good at climbing, and I'm an elf.
Now we need the slime from a slug.
Look, a slug!
Holly, perhaps you could do the asking this time. You might have to shout a little, though, because slugs cannot hear very well.
Why is that, Nanny?
Because they have no ears.
Can't we just take some slime from the ground?
You can't go around collecting someone else's slime without asking them first. It's not polite.
Hello, Mr. Slug.
Louder.
Hello. My daddy, the king, isn't well. We need some of your slime to make his medicine. Can we collect some in this jar, please?
I think that means yes. Thank you ever so much. Well done, Holly. Let's check our list. A dewdrop.
Here, Nanny Plum.
Slug slime.
Here, Nanny Plum.
Last of all, we need a frog burp. This could be tricky.
There's a frog, Nanny.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Frog. Would you be so good as to burp into this jar, please? Try and relax. That's it. Oh, we haven't got all day.
To make babies burp, you rub their backs.
Okay, I'll rub the frog's back.
I can hear something.
Hooray!
Back to the kitchen. Now, let's mix all the ingredients. Blackberry, sugar, lemon, dewdrop, slug slime, and finally, frog burp. And now, the magic words. Sugar and spice, glug, 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 burp of a frog, slime of a slug.
It's going to taste horrible.
No, Ben. Remember, it's a potion to rub on the feet, not to drink. Nobody would drink this.
Oh, my! That is bad. That did taste disgusting.
Daddy! You shouldn't have drunk it.
You should have rubbed it on your feet.
What?
I wonder what will happen now. Let's see what the book says. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, dear.
What is it?
Silly me. It's not a recipe for cold medicine after all. It's a cure for baldness. But I must say, Your Majesty, long hair really does suit you.
Nanny Plum, I think my cold has gone.
Hooray!
Achoo! Oh, I seem to have caught the king's cold.
Oh, poor Nanny Plum. Now I'm going to take personal charge of getting you better.
Can we help too?
Of course you can. The more the merrier.
Please, that's not necessary, Your Majesty.
Oh, but it is.
Achoo!
Somewhere, hidden amongst thorny brambles, is a little kingdom of elves and fairies. Everyone who lives here is very, very small.
I'm Ben Elf.
And I'm Princess Holly. Come on, let's play.
Wait for us.
Ben and Holly's Little Kingdom. Today's adventure starts at the Little Castle.
Queen Thistle's Day Off.
Da-da-doo-dum-da-dee-doo, da-da-da-da.
I'm going to visit my sister today. Will you be all right on your own?
Yes, Mummy. I'll be okay.
Don't worry, Queen Thistle.
We'll be fine.
Yes, darling. We'll all be fine.
You'll be fine. But what about Daisy and Poppy? They need looking after.
Oh, Daisy and Poppy.
But, Mummy, when you're not here, the twins are always so naughty.
Magicky, magicky.
Yes, they can be quite a handful.
What a lot of fuss about two tiny children. Just let them play, but don't let them do any magic.
Right.
Yes, Queen Thistle.
And read them a story before they go to bed.
Yes.
Very well. Goodbye, everyone. Have fun.
Bye.
Bye.
So what are we going to do? Mummy's the only one who can handle the twins.
Don't worry. Nanny will know what to do.
I think I've got some important things to do in the kitchen.
But, Nanny, aren't you going to help us look after the twins?
I'm sure you, Ben, and King Thistle can manage.
Right. We just need to keep the twins busy.
I know. Let's play a game with them.
It has to be something safe.
What about building blocks? That can't go too wrong.
Okay.
Watch Daddy build a big tower. Magic me a tower and make it big.
Ooh. Big, big.
and not to let the twins do magic.
Oh, don't worry, Holly. It's easy to make blocks little again. Little, little. There. You see, Holly?
Little, little.
Daisy, Poppy, give Daddy your wands.
Little, little.
Help! Wow, they've made King Thistle really small.
Daisy, Poppy, that wasn't funny or clever.
Little, 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 little.
They've made us little.
Don't worry, I'll magic us back to normal size. I just need my wand. My wand's too heavy. I can't lift it.
Maybe we should call Nanny Plum.
Good idea, Ben. I'll ring the bell.
Da-da-dum, do-da-dee-da, da-la-la-dee-da-da-da-da.
We need to pull harder.
Dee-da-dee. Oh, I wonder what they want. Typical. They ring for me and then they wander off somewhere.
Nanny Plum!
Eh?
We're here!
Why are you so tiny?
Daisy and Poppy did a spell on us.
Honestly, it's not hard to look after Daisy and Poppy. You just have to play with them.
We tried that, Nanny Plum. But it went a bit wrong.
What Daisy and Poppy like most is their baby dolly. Now, where is it?
Boo!
Oh, Daisy and Poppy. Where have you put your baby dolly?
Baby dolly! Baby dolly!
Hello, I'm Baby Plum. Baby Plum is lots of fun. Change my nappy, please.
Oh, no! They've changed Nanny into a doll.
Baby Plum is lots of fun. Feed me, please.
What are we going to do?
We need to get help.
Let's call my mum. She'll know what to do.
Good thinking, Ben.
This is heavy.
All together, push.
Hello, Mrs. Elf speaking.
Mum, it's me, Ben.
Oh, Ben, you sound different.
Yes, we need a bit of help. Please come quick.
Righto.
She's on her way.
Thank goodness.
I wonder what the matter can be.
Baby Plum is lots of fun. Bath me, please.
Hello, Daisy. Hello, Poppy. Can you tell me where the big children are?
We're down here.
Daisy and Poppy put a spell on us.
And we need a bit of help.
Your Majesty. We do seem to have got ourselves in a bit of a pickle.
Yes. The twins are a little high-spirited today. Could you calm them down, please?
Of course. Now, Daisy and Poppy. I'm sure you're not meant to fly so high.
Fly so high. Fly so high. Fly high in the sky.
Now, girls, put me down this instant.
Poor Mrs. Elf. Elves don't like flying.
Looks like we need even more help.
I'll call for more elves.
Hello, Mr. Elf speaking.
Mr. Elf.
We've got an emergency at the little castle. Bring the elves.
Bring all the elves.
Right-ho. Calling all elves. Emergency at the little castle.
Right-ho.
If there's a problem, what do we say?
Call an elf right away.
And what are we?
We're elves!
Baby Plum is up so fun.
The elves are here. What's the emergency?
It's the twins.
Is that you, Mrs. Elf? Where are you?
Up here, Mr. Elf.
Goodness me, Mrs. Elf. I thought you were invisible.
Invisible!
Oh, no! The twins have made all the elves invisible.
Who's going to help us now?
It's very quiet in the castle. I hope everything's all right. Hello, my little ones.
Mummy! Mummy!
My goodness, you look tired. Have you been playing with Holly, Ben and Daddy all day?
Yes, Mummy.
Where is Daddy?
Glad you're home, darling. Have you had a nice day?
Why are you so tiny?
Daisy and Puppy have been a bit naughty.
They've made us little.
I see. And where is Nanny Plum?
She's been turned into that doll. Press her tummy.
Baby Plum is lots of fun. Change my nappy, please.
I see.
My mum tried to help, but that didn't work out too well either.
And where is your mum?
Up here, Your Majesty. I'm afraid the twins have done something to all the other elves too.
What other elves? Where are they?
We're here, Your Majesty. We're invisible.
Right. And all this is Daisy and Poppy's doing?
Yes.
Okay. Let's put everything right again. Make this magic all undone.
Good evening, Your Majesty.
So, are you telling me that I've gone away for just one day and the whole kingdom couldn't look after two little children?
Yes.
We tried our best, Mummy.
But the twins really are a bit of a handful.
Thinking about it, they weren't that bad. It was rather fun, really.
Yes. I'm sure if you went away again, Queen Thistle, we'd manage just fine.
That's good, because I'm going to visit my sister again next week.
No!
Somewhere, hidden amongst thorny brambles, is a little kingdom of elves and fairies. Everyone who lives here is very, very small.
I'm Ben Elf.
And I'm Princess Holly. Come on, let's play.
Wait for us.
Ben and Holly's Little Kingdom. Today's adventure starts at the little castle.
Queen Holly.
Children, your mother and I are going away for the day on royal business.
Which means you will be at home, alone with Nanny Plum.
Ooh!
Everything will be fine, Your Majesties.
So no funny business. I don't want to come home to find the kingdom covered in frogs or jelly or anything.
No, Daddy.
Because while we're away, you represent King and Queen Thistle.
Does that mean I can be queen?
Well, I suppose it does.
Just for today.
Brilliant!
Magic car, drive on.
Bye.
Be good.
Bye-bye.
Queen Holly. I like the sound of that.
Hello, I'm Queen Holly.
Oh, hello, Ben.
Hello, Nanny Plum. Can Holly come out to play?
I'm afraid Holly's much too busy to play today. She has a kingdom to run.
Ben,
come up here, quick.
Okay. Hi, Holly.
Queen Holly to you.
What?
Mummy and Daddy have gone on a trip today and left me in charge of the whole kingdom.
Wow.
So I'm Queen Holly.
Hello?
Hello, Nanny Plum. I've come to collect Ben Elf. It's time for school.
Okay, I'll just...
Nanny, send the wise old elf up. I'll sort this out.
Very well, Your Majesty.
Enter.
Hello, Princess Holly.
I'm not Princess Holly. I am Queen Holly today.
I've got no time for these fun and games. I've come to collect Ben for school.
Aww. Wait, Ben. Mummy and Daddy are away today, so I am in charge of the whole kingdom.
Is this true, Nanny Plum?
I'm afraid so.
And I have just decided that Ben does not have to go to school today. It's the law.
Well, this is most unusual.
In fact, there'll be no school for anyone today.
No school for anyone?
Yes, it's the law, because I am Queen Holly.
As you wish, Queen Holly. Oh, dear. The children will be most upset when they hear the news. Children, I'm afraid Queen Holly has informed me there will be no school today.
Hooray! Hooray!
Hooray! What's that noise?
Queen Holly.
Hooray!
Hooray! Shush! Today shall be a holiday for everyone, even grown-ups.
Even the wise old elf.
And Nanny Plum.
Oh.
No one's allowed to work. It's the law.
But what shall we do all day?
Play games.
Yes. You've got to play games and be happy, because I am Queen Holly!
Thank you, Queen Holly!
Right, Mr. Elf. Next on the list, a delivery of food for the little castle.
Right ho, Mrs. Elf. Gosh, what a busy day.
Yes. But elves like being busy. And we're elves!
Make way! Elf at work!
There's no work today, Mr. Elf.
It's a holiday.
Is this true, wise old elf?
I'm afraid so.
But I've got an urgent delivery of food for the little castle.
I suggest you come back tomorrow.
Righty-ho! Bye!
Bye!
Talking of food, I'm getting a bit hungry.
Me too.
And me!
And me!
And me. Queen Holly! We're hungry!
Very well. I command you to eat something. Being queen is easy peasy.
But no one has made any food. Everyone's on holiday.
Oh.
Queen Holly, if you would allow the elves back to work, we could make everyone lunch.
No, no. You all have to have a nice day's holiday. It's the law.
But we're hungry. We need you.
I'll make food.
Hooray!
Now, what do you eat on holiday?
Ice cream.
Yes, that's it. You shall all eat ice cream.
Hooray! Thank you, Queen Holly!
Where are we going?
To the kitchen. We can use Nanny Plum's cauldron to make make the ice cream.
Oh, are you going to make the ice cream with magic?
Of course I am.
But Holly, your spells don't always work out quite right.
Making ice cream is easy peasy. Watch. Abracadoo, abracabong. Ice cream for everyone all day long. See, it worked.
Wow. Ice creams for everyone.
Ooh, thank you.
I'll be back with more. Oh, there's quite a lot. Will it stop soon?
I think I told it to make ice cream all day long.
Oh, dear.
We'll soon be home.
Yes, and it's good to see that the kingdom isn't flooded with frogs or jelly or anything.
Yes, Holly must be behaving herself.
There's too many ice creams.
Make it stop, Holly. Make it stop.
Stop.
For you, that's better.
Oi, where's our ice cream?
Goodness me!
I did try to stop it, Nanny, but it got worse.
Well, thank goodness the King and Queen aren't here to see all this mess.
It's the King and Queen.
Hooray!
It's very nice of you all to welcome us home like this.
May I be the first to say how pleased we are to see you back again, Your Majesties. While you were away...
Yes, yes. I'm a bit tired, so if you'll excuse me...
Ah, stop! Maybe you should go for a little walk, Your Majesty. I've just got a bit of tidying up to do inside.
Thank you, Nanny Plum, but all I want to do now is have a nice bath. Ice cream.
I'm sorry, Daddy. It's all my fault. I tried to be a good queen and make everybody happy, but it's a lot harder than you'd think.
Yes, Holly. I know it is. Especially with elves. Elves are never happy.
We are happy when we are busy.
Elves like being busy.
And we're elves!
In that case, I command you to go back to work at once.
Hooray!
And your first job will be to clean up all this ice cream.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Three cheers for King Thistle.
And Queen Holly.
Hip, hip, hooray! Hip, hip, hooray! Hip, hip, hooray!
Somewhere, hidden amongst thorny brambles, is a little kingdom of elves and fairies. Everyone who lives here is very, very small.
I'm Ben Elf.
And I'm Princess Holly. Come on, let's play.
Wait for us.
Ben and Holly's Little Kingdom. Today's adventure starts in outer space.
Picnic on the moon!
Woohoo!
Elf rocket to mission control! In a few minutes, we will land on the moon.
Very good, Mr. Elf. You are on target to land in the Sea of Tranquility.
Lovely. Once we're at the seaside, we can eat our picnic.
Oh, Nanny Plum, for the last time, we are not going for a picnic.
Why not?
Because this is a serious elf mission to To the moon!
We can still have a picnic.
Ready, everyone? We are about to go where no elf has gone before.
Or fairy.
Oh, yes, sorry, Holly. We are going where no elf or fairy has gone before.
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
Look how high I can jump.
This is brilliant.
All right, that's enough funny business. Here's my timetable for the mission. One, land on moon. Done that. Two, plant the flag.
I am now king of the moon.
Plant the flag. Done. Three, go back home.
But what about the picnic?
And you missed out the seaside.
Yes. Where's this Sea of Tranquility? I fancy a paddle.
Oh, the Sea of Tranquility doesn't have water in it. It's full of sand.
But where do the aliens go when they want to swim?
Aliens?
Nanny Plum said there might be aliens on the moon.
Well, that's just a fairy story.
Bloop.
Ah, an alien! Hello?
Aliens! Amazing!
Bleep, bleep, bleep.
Oh, that's nice. He's saying hello.
Can you speak alien, Nanny?
No.
This is Mission Control. What's going on up there?
We just met an alien!
Amazing! This is an historic, momentous occasion.
This is the biggest thing to happen ever!
Do you think he'd like a cheese sandwich?
Danny Plum, we do not celebrate historic meetings with a cheese sandwich.
Maybe the aliens can show us where the seaside is.
There is no sea on the moon, only sand.
We can still build sand castles.
Yes.
Bingo!
No! Don't start digging up the moon. You'll upset the aliens.
Look! The aliens love building sand castles.
Me too.
Time for the picnic.
No!
Magic basket, please.
Ah, magic! Nanny Plum, are you waving your magic wand around?
I haven't got my wand. Remember, it wasn't allowed on your silly elf mission.
Ah, yes.
Anyway, the magic picnic basket doesn't need a wand to work.
You just ask it for what you want.
Magic basket, please. Make us sandwiches with ham and cheese.
Yippee!
Hooray!
And now for pudding. Magic jelly.
Magic jelly!
Nanny Plum, we don't want another jelly flood.
Oh, it'll be fine.
Nanny Plum, I want you to think very carefully about what you are doing.
Whatever. Magic basket, please. Jelly, jelly!
What's he doing?
Oh, no! I forgot to say, not a lot!
Ah! Jelly blood!
Nanny! That's too much jelly!
Oh, dear. Ah!
Jelly blood!
What's happening?
Nanny Plum has flooded the Sea of Tranquility with jelly.
Nanny Plum! All the maps of the moon will have to be changed. The Sea of Tranquility is now the Sea of Jelly.
Sorry.
Sorry? The aliens will be very upset.
Jelly!
But the aliens like the jelly. They're eating it all up. They love it. I'd better make some more. Magic bath.
No! Nanny Plum, I forbid you to make any more jelly on this mission.
But look at the aliens' sad little faces. They're still hungry.
No more magic jelly.
Okay. I was looking forward to having a bit of jelly myself. Oh.
Nanny, we can't eat the picnic anyway. Our space helmets are in the way.
That's the last straw. No water in the sea, and we can't eat food. What kind of picnic is this?
It's not a picnic!
OK, let's go home.
Nanny Plum's right. It's time to go.
Well, that's what I've been saying.
Bye-bye, aliens!
Bye!
Bye-bye!
I like aliens!
Yes, they're lovely!
Everybody get ready for takeoff! I will set the controls for... Oh!
What is it?
Fuel tank is empty.
Ah, we seem to be out of fuel.
What does that mean?
We are stuck on the moon. Forever!
Oh, no!
What? What's wrong?
I put enough fuel in the rocket to get to the moon, but I forgot about getting back.
Oh, dear. That was a bit silly.
Yes. Yes, it was very silly.
It's all because of your little elf rules. If you'd let us bring our fairy wands, we could have used magic to get us back. But of course...
There's been quite enough magic for one day with that picnic basket of yours.
I didn't mean to make so much magic jelly.
Magic jelly! Of course! Nanny Plum, listen carefully. I want you to put the magic basket into the fuel tank.
Why?
There's no time for questions. Just do it.
Here's the fuel tank, Nanny Plum.
Now, ask the magic basket for jelly.
What? But you said no more magic jelly. Remember?
Yeah, I know I did, but this is an emergency.
OK. How much jelly do you want?
A lot.
Rightio.
What? How will that help?
The jelly comes out of the magic basket at amazing speed. We can use the power of jelly to make the rocket fly back home.
If I'd said that, you'd say I was being silly.
But it's not you saying it. It's me.
And the wise old elf is very wise, Nanny Plum.
I suppose he is a bit clever. OK, let's give it a go. Magic basket, please. Jelly, jelly. Lots, lots, lots. Oh, hang on, everyone!
It worked!
Hooray! Elf rocket to control! We are heading back to the Little Kingdom!
Using jelly power!
Mr. Elf, please land the elf rocket in the frog pond.
Right-ho!
Where are they?
There they are!
Stand back, everyone!
Launch the dinghy!
Ben and Holly.
We flew to the moon and back. The mission was a complete success.
Thanks to the wonders of elf cleverness.
Thanks to my magic jelly, you mean?
What?
Without my magic jelly, we'd still be on the moon.
Now, Nanny. Let's not argue over the little details. Let's just say elf skill got us to the moon and fairy magic got us home.